Spring race is Vancouver's Pavel Bure, 51 goals and counting for the Russian whiz kid, entering Tuesday's tussle with the Washington Capitals. It was a scoreless first period between these two teams until Schlager, the drop to Dixon Ward, who shoots it by Beaupre, Canucks up one zip. Second period, 2-1 Caps. Dixon Ward again doing the damage. The sweet pass to Pavel Bure, who does not miss. Number 52 for Pavel. We're tied at 2. But in the third, Michael Pavanka blows it by Kirk McLean. Washington grabs the 3-2 lead. Pavanka with 3 points in the game, but late in the third, the Canucks would come back. Schlager the shot, Beaupre the big stop, but look who's there for the rebound. Robert Kron and Don Beaupre, even though he stopped 28 shots in this game, he is not happy. He does not want a tie, but a tie is what the Caps get. So do the Canucks, who have played 9 overtime games now. All 9 have ended in ties. Flames and Kings, where it was a rough night in L.A. Referee Don Koharski checked by Luke Robitaille. Bruce McNall and Gary Bettman taking notes on that. Calgary's Brent Ashton whacking Tony Granato in the neck. Ashton served a double minor, as he should. There were some goals, by the way. 1-0 Kings in the first. Granato to Robitaille. Kings led 2-0. 4-1 Kings. Goalie's nightmare Gretzky on the breakaway. Just watch this against Jeffries. Gretzky scores his second of the game, 6th of the year. Meanwhile, Luke Robitaille looking for the hat trick. More excitement, and he gets it. Robitaille in the Kings roll, 6-2 over Calgary. Gretzky with his pair does have 6. Knickel, big game for him in the nets for the Kings, 33
saves. Games against each other this season. The Sabres and Rangers had combined for 40 goals. Buffalo trying to end a 3-game losing skid. The Rangers minus Messier back home after a successful road trip, and this one at Madison Square Garden. First period, McGillney denied by Mike Richter, but then Bob Sweeney gets the puck and scores. He had 2 goals in the game, and the Sabres had a 2-0 second period advantage. Pat LaFontaine skating in, but Richter with a spectacular save, deflecting the shot. Third period, 2-1. Ed Ulchuk coming in. Dominic Hasek poke checks the puck away. Adam Graves finds the open net, so we got overtime tied at 2. In the 0-2, Mike Gartner trying to score off the deflection, but Hasek with a kick save, and they finish in a tie. It's like kissing your sister or the guy you work with. The Rangers did keep the league's top score, Pat LaFontaine, off the score sheet. Dale Hawerchuk assisted on both Sabre goals. The Canadiens going for their 7th straight, playing at Tampa, and Tampa neutralized Montreal's speed with muscle. Sean Chambers leveling John LeClaire, and in the second period, Montreal had the 1-0 advantage, but John Tucker behind the net centers to Rob Zamaner, and he tied it and won Zamaner's 12th goal of the season midway in the period. On a 3-2 break, Sean Chambers off Adam Krejci's shot, pokes it in, and Chambers gives the Lightning a 2-1 advantage, his 12th goal of the year. Wendell Young making it stand. Benoit Brunet stopped the rebound, also stopped, as Wendell Young was outstanding. 32 saves in front of a sellout crowd, more than 10,000. The Lightning's 20th win. Montreal also lost to Ottawa. That was opening night, but they still lead the NHL.
Just 8 points in his last 9 games, slowed a bit by the flu. Oaps hopes to find a remedy in the Vancouver Canucks Thursday night in Boston. With Boston already on top, Don Sweeney's shot is stopped, but it's Oates putting in the rebound. He scored another goal to put the Bruins up 2-1. Then Joey Junot feeds Cam Neely. Third goal since his return. 3-1 Boston in the third. Watch Junot with some great work again. Double teamed against the boards, but he finds a wide open Oates, and that backhands a hat trick. 4-1, and Boston's rolling with the Hats, but the Canucks come back. Gerald Diddick, the one time, past Andy Moog. It's a 1-goal game. Final minute, 6 Canuck attackers on. They called that offsides, and it was a hideous call, but it doesn't matter because the official called it. Despite the Canuck complaints, Vancouver loses 4-3. Oates also had an assist on the only goal he did not score. Now moves past Mario Lemieux. Adam has 107 points. That's second in the league, 9 behind Pat LaFontaine. Carson, just 2 minutes in the game, scores. Not bad. Good start. But Ottawa with the answer. Mike Peluso just 43 seconds later to even it at 1. This was an offensive explosion. Lonnie Loach scores for the Kings. Then Neil Brady scores for Ottawa. Still in the first. Alexei Zhitnik to Luke Robitaille for the go-ahead goal. That was Alexei Zhitnik with the feed. That's Mike Peluso with another goal. It was 5-3 after 1. Hey, anybody want to play some defense? No. Tony Granato is 32nd of the year. Gretzky went 4 assists to Robitaille for the goal, and the Kings go on to win by the score of 8-6. Rick Knickel gets his 3rd win between the pipes of the Kings. That's Rick Knickel, the guy who spent 12 years in the minors. Kings are now at 500. Senators 0-33. 9 more chance to get a point on the road this year. In St. Louis, the
all the way out here, and There's Ronnie Francis moving. Now we'll switch to the high angle. Here's what it looks like. Here's Lemieux right here, and he makes the pass into the corner to Francis. Problem right here for the Flyers. Here's Kevin Stephens.
Oh, Carrasco's glove on the skip. Rebound to Zubov, shot by Amonte. Those fireside played by Jim Pack. Mullen at center tipped it away. Both teams want to get a line change here. Rangers try and take advantage. Shot Amonte, save Barrasso.
He making the cross pass, a nice pass from Tockett. And out comes Straka, hangs onto the puck, freezes Van Beesbrook as he's going down. Textbook 3-on-2, keep the puck moving. 2-on-1 the defenseman. And they do that extremely well to the Rangers to give the Penguins a 1-0 lead.
Straka showed some nice control of the puck with some very soft hands as he ran that across the ice. And the Pittsburgh Penguins take the early 1-0 lead. Van Beesbrook covering up on the rebound.
Earlier, he's trying to score again, but you wonder why they call the goalie Felix Potvin, Felix the Cat Toronto. Look at him get his right skate out. Looks like to the naked eye the net rippled, but the puck didn't go in there. It was the skate against the post.
Time of the power play, 3 seconds left on it. Samuelson again clears it out. Francis out of the box, and the Rangers do not...
From behind the net, quick shot here by Dirk Graham. It's in the net. Chicago leads 1-0. The Devils lead the Rangers by 2 points in the standings coming into play.
What a race, Tom. What a race. Ben Beesbrook came out and blocked it. He gave Tockett no room to wind up and get the shot off. It's a knuckleball, and with Troy Loney moving in, Van Beesbrook hangs on.
A one-on-one, Tockett on Joe.
Lemieux. McEachern winds up, Van Beesbrook kicks it out. Rebound over the net, and Francis moving in. Lemieux picks it up. Sean McEachern, the rookie. Fourth leading rookie scorer, McEachern. The middle of the power play to the blue line. Centering pass. Blocked. Controlled by Francis to Lemieux. James Patrick down low. Stepped up, blocked the pass, and they're able to clear. Murphy goes back to get it.
That pass he put through the seam to Murphy. Only Mario Lemieux can make that pass, and he does it with such great ease.
Larry Murphy, another big cannon shot. Murphy up among the top five in defensemen in scoring as number 4. Defenseman total points.
But he was clearly standing with both feet in the goal crease. And Marinelli immediately waved the goal off. Glenn Anderson had scored it.
Now, the rule used to be last year, Mick, anytime that you had that situation, as we look at it again, anytime you had a situation like this where a goal was disallowed, they automatically gave a 2-minute penalty for interference.
You see, Foligno went in there by himself. He's both feet are in the crease, and that's why it's waved off. Wendell Clark argues.
Left in the period, now 35 seconds left in the Toronto power play. Todd Gill, center ice. On the right wing side for Borshevsky. He goes back to the point now for Gill. Back for Borshevsky, but right away Chiasson was there, and Sillinger as well as the Wings able to clear. Concentration by Potvin to make the stop. And he knew he was going to get drilled, not only by the puck, but by Sheldon Kennedy.
It's going to be a long night for Rob Pearson over on that right side. He's going to play against Probert all night. He banged him about 3 times already in 2 shifts.
Now Pearson trying to rough up Kennedy. The two of them would have played against each other in the American Hockey League Calder Cup Finals last year. Where's Kennedy with Adirondack and Pearson with St. John. Cicerelli, center ice, taps it softly into the Toronto zone. Lefebvre being hooked up by Probert. Lefebvre trying to clear.
Bobby McGill unhappy with himself. He got there just a split second too late. But, you know, when you got number 19 controlling the puck, boy, you got eyes in the back of your head. The Leafs just didn't do the coverage. The Probert's tied up with Cicerelli's tied up in there. There's three Leafs there. Probert's going to come into your picture, the top right. There he is. He's waiting. Nobody there. Bang, bang, play. The three Leafs were being occupied by Dino Cicerelli. And there's Bobby Probert. See the two Leaf defensemen turn around looking at Yzerman. And that's what he can do.
Lemieux, Francis, tipped away from him into the corner. Jan Eriksson, outstanding play. Can't get it out of the zone. McEachern, Pittsburgh all jammed up on one side here. Swung around by Francis. We'll put Francis.
Francis on the weak side, Stevens on the other side. McKechnie trying to get it over to Francis. Two-man advantage for a whole minute still. McKechnie. Francis, the intended, intercepted. Can't get it out. Murphy drops it back. Lemieux in the middle. Stevens shot block right back to Lemieux. Lemieux in. Lemieux the move. Lost it as it went behind the net. Mario goes back to get it. A 5-on-3 power play for Pittsburgh, leading 1-0. Lemieux again in. Lemieux shot. Van Beesbrouck shot. Save as it hit the side of the net the second time. Stevens trying to center. Erickson there. McKechnie penalty coming up on Pittsburgh. It can't handle it. He's having a struggle here tonight. Murphy over to get it. First just playing in the power play. He's not getting a lot of ice time, so he comes out cold. Dogger's pass bounces off Gillen.
Oh, baby, what a big goal for the New York Rangers. Captain Mark Messier, shorthanded. It starts here. James Patrick gets aggressive on Lemieux. There's the puck. That was after the hit on Lemieux. Patrick has it. Here comes Messier. Brasso's well out. Little fake. And it goes right between the legs of Tom Brasso.
Four on four.
Excuse me. I'm sorry. Yeah, I thought that was shorthanded. A 4-on-4 goal. Thanks, Gary.
That's all right, Jimmy. He just came out of the box.
Oh, that's right.
He was out at center ice, and he got himself onside by getting to the other side of the red line.
Absolutely right. Messier was the guy in the box, and what a move he puts here on Tom Brasso.
Oh, what a story. Mark Messier.
In the Blackhawk net, Dave Barr moves in. Belfour makes the stop. The rebound comes to Fetisov, and Belfour would kick that away. Bruce Driver's slap shot is stopped by Belfour. Still no score. Then Keith Brown of Chicago feeding. An open Dirk Graham, who...
This is my first couple days, but the more I talked to the doctors, the better I felt about the outcome of the disease and cancer, and especially Hodgkin's. If you're going to get a cancer, that's, you know, they tell me that's the best one to get.
You elected not to talk with other athletes that had had the disease. Why was this?
I don't know. I just I felt comfortable with the information that I had at the time. The first week that I went through this thing, I talked to the doctors, especially talked to some doctors that had patients that went through the same thing that I was going through it, and I felt comfortable with the information that I had at the time.
What were the symptoms that you had or still
have?
Well,
the general side effects were dry mouth and being sore around the neck area from the radiation treatment, like a sunburn. The taste has changed. Everything tastes the same right now, which is not a very good taste. So, but the taste is coming back slowly, and it's going to take a couple more weeks before I get the full taste back. I lost some of my hair in the back, which was due to radiation.
And physically, your fitness level?
Well, the first three weeks of radiation, I felt great. Didn't have any side effects. The last week of radiation, felt tired. Also had a cold at that time, so I was sleeping a lot during the day, and that brought me down a little bit. But since I finished my radiation last Tuesday, everything is back to normal.
Great hits like this one right into your living room. And sometimes on Plays of the Week, we bring you great saves like this one by the Rangers, Mike Richter. But this week, we're going to bring you goals, goals, goals. You like fluke goals? Look at this shot from the North Stars, Dave Gagne. How did this thing beat Curtis Joseph? I should have had it. And look at John Carter of San Jose, winding up from just inside the red line, beating Calgary's Jeff Reese. Now for some great individual efforts. Look at the Flames' Robert Reichel. Unchecked, untouched by human hands, getting it to Brent Ashton for the score. Another great individual effort turned in by the Islanders' Benoit Hogue. Look at the spinorama move on Eric Weinrich and scoring against Frank Pietrangelo of the Whalers. And the best individual effort of the week, maybe of the year, Steve Thomas last Saturday morning against Philadelphia. Roofs it and scores. Milestones of the week, also in Philly. Mario Lemieux back on the ice, scoring his 40th of the season. Vancouver's Pavel Bure continues to fly, this time against Buffalo, his 50th of the year. And Winnipeg's brilliant rookie Timo Solani Pott's number 50 of the season as well. But Solani was not done. Mike Bossy's rookie scoring mark of 53 is shattered. On this
him into the boards on the bad rib cage he's got. And Al Samuelson took a shot from Messier with a stick and with his glove. And then both of them still holding their sticks. Al Samuelson retaliated.
It started on the rush. Messier was coming across the Penguin blue line early in this shift. And Samuelson stood him up, gave him a good shot of the blue line. Play continued, went down into the corner, and the two combatants met. And neither one of them is going to give an inch. Messier retaliates, Samuelson retaliates, and it looks like Samuelson is going to get the gate, maybe for that high stick. We'll have to wait for the call, but he came down pretty hard on the head of Mark Messier with the high stick.
They're
once
both
the two
leading
players paired off.
Messier is going to go too. And meanwhile, in the corner, you see the scrum. Messier and Samuelson have both been escorted off the ice by the linesman in tonight's game, Randy Minton and Jean Morin, who now come back to the corner.
Well, this is Messier coming in now. This is their second altercation. There's a shot blocked by Samuelson. They'll go to the corner, and Samuelson's going to give Messier a good shot, as everyone expects Samuelson to do. He had the stick right in there. Boom. Right into the ribs. Bangs him against the boards. You see the air exit Messier, and he comes with a big right hand. Down goes Samuelson. Messier comes again. Now watch Samuelson with a stick right there, and there's Messier with the stick back. And for that, I think they're both going to be spending the rest of the game in their respective dressing rooms.
Al Samuelson, as we've mentioned before, has the reputation of a very nasty player. And on the, depending on who you talk to, on the line of dirty.
Well, he certainly would not be my most favorite guy to play against, but he might be the most favorite guy to have on my team.
All right, we'll check the penalties when we come back. Right now, let's check in with Tom Mees.
All right, Gary, surprise at Buffalo tonight. You know, the Sabres have played 7 games against Hartford this year. They've won 6 and they've tied 1. But this is a pass to Dan Kesmer from Nick Kiprios, and Hartford leads Buffalo 3-0 in the second. Back to New York.
Kecker to Lemieux. Lemieux. More
from business. Going to Minnesota, left wing Brent Gilchrist had a
right by and behind Tom Barrasso.
He hit it with a stick. It went behind him into the wide side corner. Rangers almost had the lead. Bookaboom sends it in. Barrasso back to get it. Has trouble. Barrasso getting back in net. Rangers changing. Centering pass. Samuelson knocked it away. The only Samuelson left in this game now is Schell. Jager brings it in. Jager to Straka. Straka turning. Finds it behind.
I hope they got this back to the hit that Cicerelli made on Big Dave Ellett. Holy smoke. And does he get a payoff? You're going to see the end of it right here. Quick play. Was it Eisenman, I think, sent it out, but the play was made at the blue line to keep it in. Potvin's upset. Before the defenseman can get back there, Ellett again. But that big hit by Dino Cicerelli on Ellett started that whole play off, and then the... Oh, did he ever give it to him? My goodness. Take a look what happened here. Here's Kennedy and Anderson there. He's ugly with him there. Now watch the stick of Anderson. He gets it whacked right up across the bottom of the nose of Kennedy. Knocks the hat off, everything.
Question is Anderson done for the night?
I think he is, yep. You may be fortunate that he is, too, because Probert is looking around like, how did that happen? And who did it? Kennedy's going to go to the repair room for some possible stitches on that nose. Again, Anderson with a swing. The stick was tied up in Kennedy's arms, and all of a sudden it came loose, and he raked it washboard style right across his face. And he's obviously bleeding, whether it's a bloody nose or stitches. The 5-minute major, I believe, has been called. And Anderson is done for the night.
Now, just to bring you up to date on what's happened here in this period, there's also 2 minutes going up for Sheldon Kennedy, as well as the five to Glenn Anderson, but it was a 2-0 Red Wing lead. The Leafs scored in the first minute on the power play, and then goals 47 seconds apart. First, Borshevsky at the rim of the circle. Back to the left point, Gill. Back for Borshevsky. Right to Andrzejczyk in front, mishandled it, or he would have had a great opportunity. Now Borshevsky, number 16, out to the right point. Lefebvre shot blocked, trickling toward the net. Yzerman there, couldn't clear. Ellett tees it up for a drive. Good stop there by Chevalier.
Who's scored tons of goals here for the Red Wings in the past. Got a redirection on the power play. Cicerelli in front where he normally is. There's 25 into your pitcher. And through the legs of Felix Potvin. John O'Grodnik's second from Chiasson and Yzerman. Yzerman's second point of the night. And then another look at Cicerelli and 25 O'Grodnik getting the deflect. And Dino Cicerelli got his 28th later in the period, 13-40. The dump in, look at Dave Ellett, much bigger guy. He goes for a fly, and bang, bang, one thing leads to another. The Leafs cannot clear it out of the zone. As it goes around the wall, Markow keeps it in. And don't you know who ends up with the puck point blank with Felix Potvin? See all the Leafs leave? Dino says, oh, wait a minute, maybe I better wait here. Markow to Yzerman, to 22 on the tape, and bang, it's 4-1. Potvin, boy, is he quick. Plays deep in his net and gets away with it. And you have to be fast to play back in that crease like that, back along the goal line.
In a foot race with Gill, the two of them bump. Better off using his body to shield the puck away from Gill, but the centering pass.
The third period starts the way it ended, fast and furious and with tempers flaring. Joe Cirelli and Rick Tocchet, center stage, right at center ice in Madison Square Gardens, the main bout, and they'll cool off for the next 5 minutes. But before that, some furious action along the boards, fierce hitting, and as you mentioned, the sticks getting higher and higher with each contact made.
The coolest man on the ice is the man who needs to be, and that is Andy Van Helleman. But boy, were the sticks up. There's that knee on Phil Bourque by Shel Samuelson.
Yeah, Samuelson came in, and that could have been a penalty. That can end the guy's career, certainly end his season. You catch the knee the wrong way, and that's surgery. Bourque was understandably upset for the remainder of the shift. Had a little set-to here with Tocchet. He made another hit along the boards later on. And finally, it was Joe Cirelli and Rick Tocchet that took out their frustrations at center ice.
Phil Bourque never left the ice after that hit. That's why he was so upset. You see the sticks up on Graves there. Also upset was Grant Jennings. He had his helmet ripped off behind the play, and he thought there should have been a call.
Actually, the only requirement is the right beer. Smooth Busch beer or easy drinking Busch Light. So, head for the mountains and learn what makes the typical mountain man anything but.
If you find the interest rate on your credit card to be rather high, you should know about Smart Rate from the Discover Card. With Smart Rate, the more you choose the Discover Card when making purchases, the lower your rate can be. And the Discover Card still charges no annual fee. Now doesn't that put everything in a whole new perspective? Smart Rate, as low as 14.9%. Check your mail for your pre-approved application. It pays to discover.
Peter Anderson catches Tom Barrasso moving on this shot and almost beats him as Barrasso is coming left to right. But he gets a blocker out to make the save and keep the score at once.
Tom Barrasso, 29 wins, looking for a career season high 30. If he could get one here tonight. Power play for the Rangers, 48 seconds left on it. Rangers have...
hand over Maryland, not a scrum, but an almost a sure goal for Kevin Dineen. Goes from backhand to forehand. Don Beaupre says, not so fast, Kevin. Frustration personified. No score, end of two at the Cap Center, Gary.
I'm telling you, I talked with Philadelphia players this past week at a game. Don't tell them that they are not in the playoffs.
Absolutely not. With 40 points left in the season, anything can happen.
Philadelphia right now, 57 points. They are...
Gartner!
under terrific here. Well, that goal by Sergei Zubov caps off a tremendous game. He has played extremely well, both ends of the rink. And you'll see him here take advantage of a miscue by Stanton as his stick breaks. He's just going to take this little drop pass, heads up all the way, one hand left to right, both hands in the stick, catches Barrasso moving. Tommy loses his angle a little bit, and Zubov puts it in the long side. Look at his head up here. He's got players all over him, behind him, in front of him. McEachran's all over him. And Tommy Barrasso goes a little too far, losing the angle. And the puck goes in long side. But Gary, he has had a tremendous game at his own end of the ring. On the power play, he's been the quarterback back there for the Rangers. And this caps off a great night by number 21, Zubov.
Zubov is only 22 years old. He played 4 years with the Soviet Red Army team. And his eighth of the season from Bork at 17:24 has given the Rangers a two-goal lead. The first goal, Martin Straka had it for Pittsburgh in the first period. Then Messier tied it at 19:24 of the first.
The drink of Stevens going to the net. And the pass is going to come out. There's Tockett. Van Beesbrouck, a great save. Do they want to keep going with Richter and then with Van Beesbrouck? Or do they want to make a decision, say, this is our number one goaltender. This is the guy that's going to get us into the playoffs. And this is the guy that's going to win us a series.
His drive is deflected right in front by Pat Verbeek for his 29th goal of the season. We're slowing it down. You see it hits the shaft of Verbeek's stick. Hartford extended the lead to 3-0 as Nick Kiprios from the corner cross-ice pass to Dan Kesmer. Here's the pass, and there is Kesmer. That made it 3-0. Then on a 2-on-1, Jeff Sanderson, Hartford's leading scorer, converts the centering pass from Andrew Castles, his 33rd of the year. But Pat LaFontaine says, enough of this. I'm going to bring my team back. He knocks in this one with his glove hand, but it was unintentional. They count the goal, 4-1. This, the more conventional variety, and the power play, Mo Gildy. The shot by Howard Chuck, the rebound right out on the doorstep to an unmarked LaFontaine.